Right then, everybody. Well, let's hope we're not too late. Boy, talk about traffic, eh? Oh, I hate it.
Well, don't you mean hate, Dad?
No, boy. Well, when I said hate, I don't mean hate.
Yeah, but Dad, when you said hate, I thought you meant you ate the traffic. You know, traffic for breakfast and one for lunch.
Oh, I get your joke now, boy.
Very embarrassing, Dad, boy.
Now, anyway, let's just wait for your little brother to get here.
Oh, all right. Well, Dad, well, I'm ready for this, Dad.
Oh, it's good to have you here, Dad, Ben. Now, anyway, here we are, family. Now, this is ITV Studios, but where Baby Lamb friends will be there.
Ooh, well, this'll be good. Oh, hello. Can I help you?
Oh, yes. We're just here for an audience with program.
Well, have you got your tickets?
No, we don't have tickets. But, luckily, I already ordered the tickets online. So, have you still got the tickets ready for us?
Yes, I believe I put them in an envelope for you, Mr. Bearson.
Ooh, thank you.
Now, that comes to £15, please.
£15?
Daddy, if we're going to see the audience with, you need to pay for that nice man of that.
Yeah, but that's fine. Yeah,
£15 and all.
Yeah, £50 is okay.
There you are. Why, thank you very much. And here are your tickets, sir. Well, enjoy the show.
Oh, thanks very much. But I also hate ticket sellers.
Daddy, shush. Come on, let's just get to the theatre and have we got our tickets.
All right, Barbara. Sorry. All right then, family. Now, on our tickets, we get to sit at the front.
Ew, well, that'd be good. Why are we sitting in the front there?
Wait and see, boy, so I think that Alice might have something special for us for an audience.
Oh, okay, that's fair enough.
Yeah, indeed, my boy, indeed. Now, we just need to wait for your little brother to get here. They'll catch up in a minute.
Oh, all right. Oh, so good to enjoy this.
Yeah, sure, my boy.
Yes, all right, Dad. Me and Lisa and Maggie are here.
Ah, good. Now, and I expect that Maggie's so excited as well.
Yep, because I think she wants to see Belle the most.
But I'm sure that Baby Lamb has some surprise for Maggie too. Right then, well, let's hope Baby Lamb and friends are ready to get themselves ready to perform.
Okay, everybody. Well, this is it. This is the first time we've ever get to be an audience with series. Because we're from Capital City, USA, and we've just flown from there to the UK. Because we are at ITV Studios.
Ooh, ITV Studios? What's that mean?
It means that's like a British company.
Oh, and I was wondering, who's going to be the audience, you know, if we're doing this programme?
Well, I'll just have a quick look. Well, apparently, there's the Bearson family, that's Andy, there's Barbara, there's Bort and Ben. Oh, and I think that Bort is here. Well, Alice, I think Bort might be here as well. Woo! Oh, this is going to be so exciting, Baby Lamb. Won't you? I'm a bit nervous. Oh, it's okay, Alice. There's no need for you to be nervous. Besides, all you have to do is go out there and show Bort what you're made of. Because, after all, you have a crush on Bort.
Yeah, that's right. I suppose I better stand up like a woman.
Yeah, too little, too right. Tell you what, you get yourself ready then, and I'm sure that I'll let you know when it's time, okay?
All right.
Oh, and as for you, Belle, there's little Maggie Simpson.
Ooh, oh, I'm so excited to meet him, Baby Lamb. Oh, I'm so excited.
Yeah, so am I. And I hope you're not too nervous as much as Alice is.
Well, I'll be all right.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. Oh, and as for the rest of you, what are you all going to do?
Well, I'm going to tell some good jokes.
Ooh, but I bet a Bort would love that.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure he would. Oh, and does that also mean I get to call him Bort Dude?
Well, it doesn't matter if he was a dude. Let's just do your thing. Righto?
Righty over, Baby Lamb.
And what are you going to do, Ricky?
Let me think. Think, think, Well, do you know what? I don't know. I mean, I know that some of my ideas keep getting rejected for some reason.
Oh, well, you'll think of something, Ricky. I promise you that.
Okay. Oh, anyways, about Bob the Raccoon, right? I don't know whether I should be on the stage. Yeah, because, I mean, if Bob is on the audience, I'm definitely not going to be on it.
Oh, come on, Ricky, we need you.
Well, I'm sorry, but because of Bob, I don't approve of his pranks.
Well, suit yourself then, Ricky. If you don't want to be a part of it, fine, by me. Anyways, moving on. Okay, Donny, what are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to show them my brilliant inventions.
Oh, what, you mean like a time machine that we did on episode 100?
Yes.
Well, that'll be very good. Probably small inventions would be fine.
Right, okie dokie.
Right, anyways, everyone, let's keep quiet now because the show is about to begin.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Yeah, so am I. Hopefully not to be too nervous.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages. Now, you're probably wondering why we're doing an audience with? Well, we may have already had the Bearsons and the Hairbear, obviously, but this time they flew from capital city of US of the A to the UK, because this is where ITV started doing it since the beginning of the 60s. And now, ladies and gentlemen, because it's a very special program, and it may be a random one, but that's why it's called An Audience with Baby Lemon's Friends. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give you the little lamb that never sleeps, it's Baby Lamb! Give him a round of applause!
Thank you! Wonderful! Well, it's so good to see you all! Well, this is the first time I've ever get to do that. In the UK area. Why, this sure is exciting. Now, the reason why we're all here, because I think we got some great entertainment coming your way, including one very special short, which was created by none other than Mattxplores and Simon A, who was my creator.
Excuse me, I have a question.
Huh? Who said that?
Me. I'm just Andy Benson. Remember me?
Oh, yes, I remember you. Oh, anyway, have you got a question?
Yes. Who is Simon A anyway? And what did he do?
Well, I'll explain, Andy. Well, Simon A is the creator of the web series Baby Lamb and Friends.
Oh, I see. Very interesting.
Yeah, I know. And also, one thing that Simon A is very good at, playing the piano.
Oh, piano? Oh, well, that looks like a very great hobby there.
Yeah, I know, right? Boy, talking about pianos, I do have a piano, and of course, we're saving that for a very special something, because it's all dedicated to that young raccoon there, who I heard that, who had a crush on the most. And you all probably know, it's Alice who has a crush on Bob the most.
Ooh. Well, boy, did you hear that? I think Baby Lamb did say that Alice might be in it later.
Ooh, oh, this is so awesome, Dad.
Yeah, I did promise you that, boy. Anyways, carry on, Baby Lamb.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Bearson. Now, as I was saying before Andy asked me a question, As I was about to say, if you have any questions that you want to ask, feel free, because it's an audience with Baby Lamb and Friends. And after all, I have lots of friends too. Well, such as Alice, which I've already told you about. There's Belle Butterfly, who I had a crush on, which you'll probably see in a short in a minute. And we also got some male ones, such as Cal, who's my best friend, Ricky, and also Donnie, Oh, and how can we forget, don't we say it, Cassandra Cat, who has recently just joined a gang. Oh, I have a question. Who said that this time? It's only me, baby lad. I bought Bearson, by the way. Oh, all right, bored. What's your question? Will I ever get to see Alistair perform in front of me and my family here? Well, it's not just you, Bort, it's just your family. Well, that's what I said. Just me and my family. Oh, well, you're in for a big treat, Bort. I promise you that later. Yeah, gotcha. Thank you. Right then, now, to begin the an audience with, here we go with our animated short created by none other than Mattxplores. Right, take it away, Mr. Cartoonist.
Oh, with pleasure. Oh, jeez, I hate that saying.
So, is it okay if you can help me win her heart? Your eyes sparkle like the stars in a beautiful night sky.
No, Teller, your lips are like those petals that grow.
Oh, that's really sweet.
Your beauty is like... Huh? I'll be right back. What happened there, cow?
I've been playing Pac-Man.
Ooh! Huh? Oh. Ooh.
I brought something for you.
Hold on. It didn't work. Huh? What on earth is he up to? I'll save you, Belle!
Save me!
What am I supposed to do?
Save her from a train!
I didn't realize I was going to have to drive! Hang on, Belle! I'm coming! Well, time to be a super lamb! Right. Whoa! Oh, beautiful!
What was that for? I almost got run over by a train!
I just wanted to do all of this because I love you! Huh? What?
It's not about the things that make you happy. It's about sharing with you how much you love and care for what you love.
Oh,
no matter how much they love you back.
Oh, that's nice for you to say. So, now what?
I mean, there's nothing else to do right now and...
Oh...
Baby lamb. Flowers. I always love flowers. Baby, that's so sweet of you.
Hey, that's not how it's supposed to go. Ow!
The end. Well then, everybody, that was our short, random Romeo. What did everyone else think?
Well, that short was really good, baby love. Yeah, I guess Matt. Well, I didn't even know who Mattxplores is.
Well, apparently, he's a shipper of me and Belle.
Oh! What? Ship? Ship?
Alright, who said that?
Oh, sorry about my son there, baby love. I think he's only just teasing.
I don't think that's very funny.
What? How dare you just say ship to Baby Lamb here? You know Baby Lamb and Belle don't like it when they people ship them.
Oh. Sorry, Dad. Sorry, Baby Lamb. It's okay. Most people do that all the time. Ship.
What? Don't say it.
Chips. Chips? What is he all about, Andy?
Well, obviously, that's just a prevention from saying ship again.
Oh, chips. So, Andy, well, never mind you've asked me a question earlier on. Now it's my turn to ask you. What do people call them if they like French fries in English?
Well, baby, I'll explain. The French fries, however, in English, they are called chips. They're potato chips.
Oh. Well, that's certainly interesting. Mind you, we only have French fries when we have our dinner there.
Oh, and I take that you live in Capital City, yeah?
Yep, that's right. That's why we flew from Capital City, US of A, to here.
Well, that is great news. And once again, I apologise for my boy's behaviour.
That's alright. Yeah, most people do tend to ship us like that, especially Mattxplores.
Yeah, too right. But you either behave yourself or you won't get to see Alice today.
All right, I'll behave.
Good. Now, besides, boy, you need to use your manners.
Very well.
Right, anyways, yes, me and Bort loves that short.
Yeah, but I love that short too, Dad. And yes, baby, love, I love that short.
Yeah, so do I, Benny. Yeah, me too. And I certainly do.
Well, it seems that you all enjoyed.
Well, I enjoyed that too.
Who said that?
Me, Mr. Dark Brown Bear, who is called the Hair Bear.
Oh, hello there. Well, don't worry, I know I'm not scared of you, so please don't eat me.
Why would I want to eat you?
Well, I just thought grizzly bears are a bit grisly.
Well, not this one.
Oh, okay. So anyway, so now that you've all seen the shorts, and now let's give it up for my next friend, because you haven't seen my girlfriend yet. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Belle Butterfly. Come up here, Belle.
Thank you very much. Oh, thank you very much. I'm so excited for this.
Yeah, so am I, Belle. Well, everybody, this is Belle Butterfly, my girlfriend. And the reason why she's here right now, because I think that we're doing a meet and greet. Because I heard that there's a special baby named Maggie who's excited to see Belle the most.
Ooh, well, Maggie, did you hear that? I think someone wants to see you.
Yeah, Belle.
Yeah, I know. Baby Lab, is it okay if I bring Maggie along with me to the stage?
Aye, of course you can. Right, ladies and gentlemen, Andy Bearson and Maggie. Well, Belle, you might get to see Maggie after all.
Oh, I'm so excited for this.
Yeah, so am I.
Right, come on then, Maggie. Right, let's get onto the stage, yeah? Yeah, all right, I'll carry you. Yeah, that's a good girl.
Chip!
What? I'll deal with you later. Right, I'm coming, baby lamb. Hold on. All right then, Maggie. Now, are you ready to see Belle now?
Yes, Daddy.
Yeah, good. Oh, and I'm really sorry about Maggie. She keeps calling me Daddy, which, although I am not her real father.
Oh, that's all right. You make a very great father.
Ooh, thanks very much. Well, Maggie, ask her if she wanted a hug.
Okay. Hi, Belle.
Oh, hi, Maggie. Oh, I heard great things about you. Want a hug? Huggies. Oh, okay, huggies.
Aw, well, that is so sweet. Yeah, for once, I agree with you, Andy. Yeah, that's why Maggie was so adorable, like Belle.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Well, boy, why can't you be more like Maggie?
I don't know, Dad.
Never mind. As I said, I'll be with you later. Well, Maggie, did you enjoy giving Belle a nice hug?
Yes, Daddy.
Yeah, but I'm glad you enjoyed the hug. Right then, right, I'm just going to take some photos of you and Belle. Belle, is it okay if I take a photograph with you and Maggie in it?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay. All right, Maggie, now, why don't you just get off the Belle now and stand up and give me a big smile?
Okay, Daddy.
Right. All right, same to you, Belle. Right, say cheese.
Cheese. Milk.
Yeah, she means cheese, Belle.
Okay.
Right, I'm just going to take two photos. Click, click, click. There we go. That's that. Thank you very much, Aunt Belle. All right, Maggie, we can get off the stage now.
Okay, Daddy.
And Maggie, stop calling me Daddy. Just call me Andy.
Daddy.
Andy.
Daddy.
Andy.
Andy the Big Elephant. Andy the Big Elephant? Whoa! That was cheeky.
Oh, that is so funny.
Yeah, I know, right? Never mind. We'll get off the stage anyway. Oh, and thank you very much for letting us on the stage for a bit.
Oh, you're welcome, Mr. Bearson.
Yeah, you're quite welcome. Well, why don't you and Maggie go back to the seats now?
Okay then. Right, thanks very much. Right, come on, Maggie. Now, let's get you back to the seats now. Oh, and you can be with Ben now.
Okay, Daddy.
And Maggie, for the last time, it's Andy.
Andy the Elephant.
See you later, Aunt Belle. And same to you, baby lad.
Yeah, all right, Mr. Bearson.
All right, Mr. Bearson. Bye, Maggie.
Bye-bye.
And that was Maggie Simpson, everyone, with Andy Bearson. Yeah, I'm so glad you're on the stage. Well, what do you think of Maggie, Aunt Belle?
Wow, she was so adorable.
Yeah, just like you.
Oh, thanks, baby lad.
Ship! What? What did I just say?
I meant chips.
What? You either behave yourself, or you won't see Alice at all.
Yeah, but Dad...
What?
Yeah, but Dad...
What?
Hey, who's arguing?
Oops. Sorry, baby lamb. Only because Bort kept saying ship.
Oh, yeah, I suppose he kept saying it now. Anyways, I think we'll just say, give her a round of applause for Belle Butterfly. Oh, Belle, why don't you go back to the backstage?
Oh, okay, baby lamb. Well, bye, everyone. See you soon. Bye, Maggie. Bye-bye.
Belle Butterfly, everybody. Right, okay, so now we have Belle, although a sudden raccoon has already kept saying ship. Oh, I just don't know why he keeps saying that. It should be bad for the theatre, you know.
Yeah, what? I agree.
Dad, I certainly don't want to be banned.
What? You're either going to behave yourself or no Alice.
Fine, fine. All right. I won't say that again.
Good. Now, promise me, boy.
Promise.
Good. Now, anyways, baby, now, I'm really sorry about my son. He's not usually like that, you know.
That's all right, Mr. Bearson. Well, I suppose it was his fault for saying ship in the first place.
Yeah, I know.
Well, mind you, Andy, if he keeps saying ship, then we're going to have to cancel it.
But, baby lamb, Bob wants to see Alice as well.
Oh, yeah, I quite forgot about her. Well, that's okay. Now, don't you worry, everybody. Now, we're going to have a little break from it, so we'll be right back after the break. So please, don't go away. We'll be right back. Okay, everybody, and welcome back to a very special program. An audience with me, Baby Lamb, and friends. Okie dokie. Now, we may have already had Belle earlier on. Oh, and once again, I'd like to apologise for those who have seen Andy's butts.
I just don't know why Andy kept saying bought for. Well, obviously, I heard he's trying his hardest to be a good father. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. Although sometimes it didn't work very well in the end, but that's why I let Barbara do most of the fixing up for me.
Oh, is it true, Barbara? Is it true that you always help your husband?
Yeah, that's right, because he's very abusive to his son, you know, except Ben.
Oh, well, why is he on earth when he abuses his eldest son?
You see, well, whilst Andy was out for searching for food, well, he found an abandoned raccoon.
Oh, so my guess is that he was the eldest.
Yes.
Oh, well, that is a very sad story. But thank you for telling me that, though, Barbara.
You're very welcome.
Okay, now, I got the piano at the backstage, but although I will need some help from a strong bear, because I'm just going to let Alice do the performance.
Well, boy, well, did you hear that? You did see Alice after all.
Ew, what, does that mean I can misbehave?
No, it doesn't, boy.
I knew that, Dad. I'm just saying.
Oh, it's fine. Anyways, yes, I'm a strongest bear, and I'll help you with the piano.
Oh, okay. We'll be right back in about 10 minutes. 10 minutes?
What? I'm only going to help Baby now to get the piano to the stage. Just hold your horses.
I haven't got any horses, Dad.
That's just a figure of speech, boy. That means hold on.
Oh, got you, Dad.
Right, I'm coming to help you anyways.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Andy Bearson again, but this time he's going to help me with the piano. We'll be right back again.
Oh, hi everybody, and welcome back. Oh, and I'm sorry if I take off because it was a very heavy job for a little lad, but it's a good thing he did ask me to help.
Yeah, thanks very much for your help, Mr. Bearson.
Oh, you're quite very welcome.
Now, why don't you introduce Alice to the audience out there?
Oh, okay. I'd be honoured to. Now then, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please give a warm welcome to the crush of my sons, Alice Polynia, which I think that she's got a song, and it's called I've Got a Crush on Someone. And here she is, everybody. Right, well, I better get off the stage. Right, and play that piano there, Mr. Lamb.
With pleasure, Mr. Bearson. Oh, and I believe you forgot to put Lavarachi.
Oh, yes. Sorry, baby lamb. I meant, ladies and gentlemen, Alice Polynia, with Lavarachi on the piano. Right, I better get off this tape right now. Right, I'm coming, boy. Hold on. Oh, and enjoy the show, boy. Thanks, Dad.
I've got a crush on someone. Guess who I've got a crush on? You, sweetie pie, all the day
it's
and
Alice.
Time, I never had the least notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you coo? Could you care for a cunning cottage? We could share, the world will pardon my mind.
Oh.
Cause I've got a crush, baby, on you. How glad a million laddies, from millionaires to caddies, would be to capture me. But you had such persistence, you wore down my resistance. I fell, and it was swell. You're my big and brave and handsome Romeo.
Sounds
sounds like she called you how Romeo, I won you,
I shall never, never.
Yeah, too right, Dad.
It's not that you're attractive, but oh, my heart grew active when you
Alice is touching my key.
Came into view. I've got a crush.
Ew, she's giving me a wink.
Sweetie pie.
I love Alice.
All the day and night time. Hear me sigh. I never had the least notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you could you care for a cunning cottage? We could share the world, will pardon my much, 'cause I've got a crush, my baby, on you.
Yay! Bravo to Alice!
Bravo!
Yeah, bravo!
Bravo! Daddy, Papa! You're thinking me bravo! Sorry.
Well, boy, what do you think of Alice's performance? Boss, are you okay, boy? Oh, I think I know why. I think he's in love with Alice. Well, it seems that Bord really is deep in love with her now. That's all right. Well, I suppose I'll ask Baby now. If that's okay with him, he can go to the backstage if he wants to. Right, shut up, everybody.
Well then, everybody, what do you think of Alice's performance there?
Well, we all think it was beautiful, that Baby Lamb. And I'm very sorry about my son there. He's all a bit lovey-dovey.
Oh, I see. So, does that mean that Bort wants to go and see Alice again?
If that's all right with you, Baby Lamb, is it okay if Bort goes see Alice in the backstage?
I'll have a word with the manager first.
Okay.
Right, be back in a minute, everybody, whilst I have a word. Till then, here's Cal McMoo with his practical jokes. Over to you, my best friend.
Hello, everybody. I'm Cal, and I'm a friend of Baby Love's friend. Moo. Oh, and I also heard that there's a sudden port dude has a crush on someone. Well, it's not Belle, and it's definitely not Cassandra. No, which is more likely than Cassandra, maybe now. And whilst he's going to get the manager up for something or other, I will tell you all some good jokes.
Jokes? Now that's one thing you like. Bort, you can stop thinking about Alice now. Bort. What, Bearson?
Oh, sorry, Dad. I've just drifted off there.
Oh, so does that mean that you really love her?
Yes, because of her singing.
Oh. Well, the important thing is, boy, glad that you enjoy. Do you recognise this animal?
Yes, of course I do. It's the smelly cow.
What? You do realise it's cow, McMoo?
Oh, yeah, I forgot. My dad is the smelliest of bear in town.
I do not smell!
And dad says blah blah blah!
I do not say blah blah blah!
Well, look at that dear Bort, everyone! They're just arguing! So hilarious!
A Bort? How dare you give a dog away?
Sorry, Dad, but at least Cal seems to enjoy the laugh.
Oh. Well then, Cal, well, me and Bort, I'm so glad to see you.
Boy, thank you very much, Mr. Bearson. And same to you, Bort, dude.
Oh, thanks, Cal. Oh, and I'm really sorry if I accidentally called you a smelly cow again.
That's okay, dude.
I forgive you. Anyways, I heard that you had a crush on someone.
Yes, and it's Alice, by the way.
Oh, yes, I know that now. Anyways, let's move on to the jokes.
Oh, and it better be not a 100-year-old joke.
What? You do realise that the chicken joke thing is not 100. Besides, it was only being used for generations.
Oh, I'm just kidding.
Oh, that's right. Right, carry on, Cal.
Okay. Why did a chicken cross the road?
Well, we all don't know.
To go to the other side.
Ah, very amusing that, Cal. Very good.
Why, thank you. Here's another joke. Let's see. I got it. What's green and hairy that goes up and down?
Well, I bet you don't know this one. No, Dad, I don't. Well, we all don't.
A gooseberry stuck in a lift.
Well, Cal, that is hilarious. I think that Lisa Simpoo is a gooseberry.
What? God, I am not a gooseberry.
You're a beatnik. Beatnik? What? I am not a beatnik. Yeah, shut up, Lisa.
What? Take this joke seriously.
Yeah, but I am, Dad, because Cal said that.
Ah, I see. Yeah, but that doesn't mean you have to call her that.
All right, I know that now.
Sorry. It's fine, boy. And don't ever call him a gooseberry again, or you won't be seeing Alice in bed backstage.
Sorry, Dad. Sorry, Lisa.
That's okay, bud. I forgive you.
Good.
Forty beep.
All right, I'll be safe.
Good. All right, carry on, Cal.
Oh, thank you very much. Okay, here's one more joke before Baby Lamb gets back. Okie dokie. Let me see. What can I think of a joke? I got it. What do you call a dinosaur with no eyes?
Oh, I don't know, Cal. What do you call a dinosaur with no eyes?
Do you think he saw us?
Well, do you think that Baby Lamb saw us?
But you do realise that Baby Lamb is not here back yet.
Oh, yeah, I'm just joking, Dad. You told me to take the joke seriously, and I did. But you should be the same with mine.
I doubt that. Yeah, good joke anyway, Cal.
Well, thank you very much. Well, anyways, everybody, that's all the jokes I can think about right now. And I shall hand you back over to Baby Lamb now. Over to you, best friend.
Thanks, Cal. And thank you very much, Cal, for doing the jokes. And I heard that some people are laughing at some. Especially at the chicken joke, which is 100 years old.
What? Stop it.
Sorry, Dad.
I really am getting fed up with this now. Anyways, that Baby Lamb. Sorry perhaps for the interruption there. Yeah, because Mort thinks that the chicken joke is 100 years old.
Oh, well, I didn't know that it was 100 years old.
Well, actually, it was. It's because it was an old joke that people used centuries ago.
Oh, well, that's one interesting fact there. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Bearson.
You're quite welcome. Now, carry on.
With pleasure. Now, as I was saying before, someone interrupted me, which is not likely in this programme. Now, I've had a word with the manager, and he thought about it for a few minutes, and then he said, because that I am a random lamb, I have decided that Bob Bershon should come onto this backstage to see Alice in person.
Well, boy, did you hear that? Baby Lamb said that you could go and see Alice in the backstage. Oh, and you'll have to go by yourself. I know how much you love Alice.
Yeah, thanks, Dad.
Bought an Alice chicken in a tray. Be quiet, you. Got you, boy. That'll teach you a lesson for interrupting. I'd say shit from earlier.
All right, Dad. Yeah, wish me luck, Dad. I don't suppose you got any flowers, have you?
Flowers? Oh, I get it.
Baby lamb, I don't suppose you got any flowers, have you? Well, I could always pick some from the fields.
Oh, but wouldn't that interrupt the show there?
I know I'd sometimes interrupt. No, it's okay. I'll be as quick as I could, but I'll have to let Bort Bess into the backstage first.
Oh, okay. Right, boy, off you go.
Thanks, Dad. Okay, everybody. It's Bort Bearson again, and this time he's coming to join me for a bit. So, what do you say, young man? Well, see you later, everybody. I won't be too long, and you might get to see me dancing with a special person. Yeah, that's right, because I know you how much you love to dance.
Yeah, with a girl.
Yeah, especially if Alice was one of your dreams.
Yeah.
Well, goodbye, everybody.
Peace, man.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. Put best in, everybody. See you later.
Yeah, see you later, son. Good luck. I'm very proud of you, though. Right then, family. Well, I think the best thing we can do is probably we can get some ice cream at a confectionery stand.
Oh, all right, Daddy. Well, I can do some.
Yeah, me too, Mum.
Yeah, me too, Benny. Me too.
Now, chill a minute, everybody.
It's backstage. Hey, backstage? Why on earth would Bort want to do that?
I'll get used to it. Just because that baby lamb have already decided that Bort should be at the backstage to see Alice in person. So you're going to have to deal with it. As Simon 8 would have said, it's a random thing to do.
Alright. As I said, it's backstage.
Excuse me, miss. You have a special visitor.
Oh, send him on in.
Oh, okie dokie. Alright, young man, fine. Get in there.
Thanks, sir.
Hiya, Bort.
Ooh, hello, Alice. Ooh, loved your performance there.
Well, thank you, young man. Remember me?
Yes, I remember you. Ah, Cara Mia. Ooh. Cara Alicia. Well then, Alice. Yeah, that was beautiful thing you've done. Yeah, well, only because Baby Nun did ask about it if I want to come and see you. And here I am.
Well, Bort, I'm so glad you liked my performance.
Yeah, well, yeah, thanks very much. So anyways, Alice, I heard that you and your friends have flown from Capital City to the UK.
That's right, Bort. Yeah, because you see, I was planning a special surprise for when you come to the UK.
Oh, yeah, but of course I live in the UK, and you belong in Capital City. Yeah, at least I know the reason why you had to be here. Just because you're doing a special at audience for.
Yeah, that's my Bort. Yeah, of course. So, anyway, so Bort, you'll be okay if you and I dance with each other in front of the audience.
Oh, well, are you sure, Alice? You're not trying to seduce me, are you? Just because I'm trying my hardest in the atheist home?
No, of course not.
Ah, that is great news. I mean, if you do try to seduce me, my dad will probably freak out.
No, he wouldn't.
Well, although he does tease me a bit, though. But, yeah, sure, why not, Alice? I mean, after all, why don't you ask Baby Lamb about it?
Oh, okay, then, Bort. I'll be ready. But until then, have a nice sit down, and I'll give you a nice neck rub.
Ooh, neck rubs? Ooh, that'll be good. Oh, and of course, this program is going to be over right now. So, we'll be right back after the break. So, don't go away.
You too, now, Bort. That's Baby Lamb's saying.
Oh, sorry.
See you after the break. Well, I'm going to give you kissies, Borty boy. Hi again, everyone. Welcome back to the show.
Oh, yeah. Hi, everyone. Hey, sorry if I had to be at the backstage. Yeah, it's just because my dad did ask Baby Lamb very nicely, though. Yeah, it's because I'm with Alice right now. Oh, and don't worry about the neck rubs. I've already had one already. Well, hopper, hopper. Hello, young lady.
Is there a grandmother at home?
Oh, Morty, you're very cheeky. Well, I never knew you were so smart. You're so handsome.
Handsome? You really think so?
Yes, it's because you're so strong, clever, and daring. How can I ever thank you for giving me a nice compliment? I know.
Well, it was nothing, really. Well, I'd do anything to please a nice girl who gave me loads of kisses.
Oh, Miss Alice, are you alright there?
Oh, yeah, I'm alright, because I gave you too many kisses.
Oh, alright. Tell you what, hang on. I heard that you and Upport are doing dancing together.
Yeah, that's right. Could you just pass him some water?
Oh, yeah, with pleasure, miss. Right, here you are, big old man. Have a nice drink.
Thanks very much. Yeah, I needed that. Well, that was... Oops. Well, pardon me. Pardon me.
That's all right. That's so funny anyway. Anyway, can we get onto the stage now?
Yes. Let's do it then, Alicia.
Oh, why'd you call me that?
It's just a little joke.
Well, you better stop calling me that. That's annoying, you know.
Oh, sorry. I meant Alice. During the beginning.
Yeah, okay. So, should we get ourselves ready, buddy?
Yeah. Of course, if we're going to dance in front of an audience, I think I might need a suit.
Oh, it's all right, but, well, here's a smart suit for you.
Oh, thanks very much, Dieters. Yeah, don't worry, I got it ready.
Oh, that's great. Let's dance, Daddy-o.
Yeah, good idea. Well, see you in a minute, everybody. On stage, and also 5 minutes later. Oh, thank God, that's back to normal. Hi, everybody. Well, we're back again. Oh, and I also heard that a board has requested me if Alice and Board can dance together in front of the whole audience. Well, let's hope nothing will embarrass them from doing it, because Alice is not so nervous anymore.
Yeah, well, I'm so glad to ask. Oh, and how's Board, by the way?
Well, I think he's fine, but also he's very lovey-dovey at the moment.
Oh, yeah, it's a good thing I did ask you that.
Yeah, he sure did. Yeah, mind you, he would have been a perfect gentleman to Alice.
Yeah, it's a good thing we do need Alice to help Bort to become a gentleman.
Oh, yeah, I know. Oh, and I expect that Belle would help him too.
By the time he gets his own show?
Well, that depends, really. That depends on what he does. After all, it is a random verse, after all.
What are you going to introduce now?
Well, we're going to introduce you to Bort and Alice dancing together.
Ooh, well, that'll be lovely.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, me too, Mum.
I can't wait to see Borty Boy.
Later.
Shh.
Sorry.
That's all right.
All right, over to you, baby lamb. Right, thank you very much, Mr. Bearson. And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's now time to see the lovely couple, although not really cute or adorable, but let's just say an awesome couple. So here they are, everybody. Here's Bort Bearson and Alice Polynia. Right, come on to the stage, you two. Yeah, we're coming.
With her, for your heart.
Yeah, go, Bort.
Yeah, go on, my little bro. Oh, I meant big bro. Yeah, you could do it. And remember, raccoons and bears can do different things.
Yeah, I agree with you, buddy.
Yeah, go on, Bobo.
Yeah, that's right, Maggie. Look, Bort is standing with Alice.
Borty cutie.
I know. Oh, of course, Maggie. We can't call Alice cute because I heard that she get angry.
Oh, sorry, Daddy.
Don't worry, Maggie. At least you didn't call her back. That's the important thing. Right, carry on dancing, my son. I'm so proud of you.
There from Bort and Alice. Boy, mind you, these two make a very great couple. Well, in fact, awesome couple, that is. Well, by the time Bort gets his own cartoon show, yeah, that really depends on two creators. Mine is Simon A, and the Bearsons belong to a certain young man. But I don't know what their name is, though. But whatever it is, I'm not going to mention that. So anyways, now, I think that Bort and Alice will be taking their bows in a few seconds. But as of right now, what's my verdict for Bort and Alice dancing? Well, it was beautiful, because it's like Bort being a prince, and he's dancing with his very own princess. Princess Alice, that's what she will be called the next time if they meet again. So I give it 10 out of 10. What does the Bearson family have to say about that?
Well then, Bort, that was brilliant dancing with Alice there. Yeah, because as Baby Lab did say, you were a prince and you danced your own princess. So I give it 10 out of 10.
Well, I agree, Bundy. 10 out of 10 as well.
Yeah, and wow, I'm so proud of my big brother. Yeah, and I'm also proud of Alice too, for dancing together. So I give it 10 out of 10.
Yeah, me too. 10 out of 10. What's your focus, Maggie?
Ben.
Yeah, I think she means 10. She means 10 for...
Ah, thank you, Maggie. But anyways, now let's have Bort and Alice take their one last bow. Oh, and I think Bort will be giving a speech to the family right now. Over to you, Mr. Bort. Why, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much.
Thank you, thank you, thank you very much.
Right, now for my speech. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Now, because that I've danced with Alice, and I know that me and Alice makes a very great couple, in which we will be awesome in the future. Yeah, because seeing Alice in an audience with them tonight. Yeah, because, you know something, everyone? Alice is now my loveliest girlfriend in the world.
Oh, Borty.
Alice. Alice in Wonderland.
Alice in Wonderland! What, Dad? Sorry, boy. Now, ow! What? Anyway, finish your speech, boy. Thank you. Sorry, everybody. Yeah, I didn't mean to do that. Don't worry, it's just a pretend sound of it. It's not real, you know. Just like old cartoons. So anyways, as I was saying before, Dad the Dumbo interrupted me. Now, because I think Alice is definitely my loveliest girlfriend in the world. And don't worry, the reason why I called her Alice in Wonderland, because that's what I would have done if Alice had not appeared in Wonderland, because me and Alice would have gone there on ourselves. Don't we, my darling?
Yeah, of course we do. But that means we get to see some weird things.
Yeah, and you know something? Things aren't always what they seem, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, and of course, now the next time, if I get my own cartoon series, which I don't really know if it's going to happen or not, but it's up to my creator, George Buxton, who has created this program for all of us to be here. Oh, and also, and the next time if me and Alice gets married, which I truly doubt we will be, but let's just say we're just as friends. Aren't we, Bass?
Yeah, we sure are. But of course we're not going to get married, are we?
No, that's too soon.
I promise you it's too soon.
But anyways, nonetheless, me and Alice are definitely boyfriend and girlfriend now. But that means we get to do our own dates as well. So, apparently, that's my speech. And I thank you. Oh, and I'm also sorry, Dad, if I had to shoot you as pretend. That's all right, boy. And I'm also sorry if I cheated you. That's okay. All right, baby lad. Right, over to you. Thanks very much, Upwart. And that was his own speech about Bort now being boyfriend to Alice now. That's after the success of the crossover episode, which you might have seen from the 11th series of the Bearsons. That's where we came in for the first time in history. Yeah, so anyways, now I know we've already had Belle earlier on this afternoon, and the same with Alice. The one that she kept on going the longest is because of her board in shining armour.
Yeah, thanks, baby lad.
Oh, you're very welcome. And, of course, I think we may have already had Cal doing the jokes. Yeah, it's just about we haven't had Cassandra Cat, Cal McMoo. Oh, sorry, I meant Ricky Bowers and Donnie the Dolphin, yeah. So, first of all, I give you Donnie Dolphin to show us his adventures. Take it away, Donnie.
Why, thank you.
Well, see you in a minute, everybody. After two performances from Ricky and Donnie later, but let's say Donnie's adventures is the best ever. And that was Donnie first, and then we've had Ricky. So yeah, Donnie's adventures were amazing though. Yeah, like the time of when he built a time machine that travels back to the land first. That was back in episode 100 of our own show. Yeah, 100 episodes. Can you all believe that?
I have a question.
Ooh, sounds like we've got another question. And it's from Andy again. And what's your question?
Well, my question is, how on earth did you reach 100 episodes?
Well, it was easy, really. But after we've done the 95th episode of Baby and I Were Friends, we've had Cartoon Shorties Night.
Cartoon Shorties Night?
Oh, that is interesting, though. Yeah, too right. Then we show off some classic tunes.
Oh, well, that's interesting. So that was the reason you reached 100.
Yes.
Ooh. Okay. Now, by the way, I enjoyed looking at Donnie's adventures. Very amazing. Oh, and as for Ricky, well, I guess that he must have heard that he hates sport.
Oh. Oh dear, looks like it's happened.
Yeah, don't worry.
I know that that boy didn't mean to misbehave, but by the time he moves to Capital City, if he wants to, he will definitely be a changed man. That means he'll be more likely to grow a moustache and his hair.
Oh, well, that might would have happened because if it wasn't for the random verse.
Yeah, tell me about it. So, anyways, I'll let you carry on.
Thanks, Andy. Now, anyways, we got one last performance here. And I think this time, we'll be having Cassandra here. But I don't know what she's doing at the moment. Well, as I said, it's a random verse. So, anyways, let's give it up for Cassandra Cat. Over to her now. Right, it's okay, everybody. Now, because Cassandra is probably the last friend that you haven't met yet, and if you want to ask Cassandra any questions, feel free. And of course, we will be having a fashion show that comes from three girls that we got. Belle, Alice, and, Cassandra, obviously. After she came onto the stage, and here they are now. Take it away, girls.
Hi, everyone. I'm Cassandra Cat, and I'm new to the Lamb Gang.
Oh, hi, Cassandra.
Oh, who's that?
That'll be me. I'm Andy Bearson, by the way.
Oh, hello there.
I have a question. What made you join the Lamb Gang?
Well, you see, it's because I decided to join the Lamb Gang. You know, be with friends.
Oh. And is that the reason why that baby lamb was turned into a dog?
Somewhere. So I was new at that time.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay. Well, just asking. Oh, a nice outfit, by the way.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bearson.
You're very welcome. Oh, and I have a question.
Oh, you said that now?
It's just my son, Ben, obviously.
Oh, hello there. I'm Ben, and I have a question.
Why are you afraid of water? It's kind of a long story, really.
Oh, come on. I'll keep it a secret if you do.
All right, here goes. I have a condition.
You have a condition? Well, you've had a condition. Oh, that's sad to hear.
I know. Just don't ask me that again.
Oh, sorry. I'm just a bit curious, that's all.
Don't worry about that. It happens, but... because cats hate water, you know.
Oh, yeah. Well, luckily, my cat, Benjamin, that's after my name, well, he hates water too.
Oh, well, that's something common.
yeah, I know. Yeah, but I'm very happy to say. Lovely to see you, young lady.
Thank you very much, Ben. Oh, but I have a question. Oh, who said that this time? It's Bob and me, Barbara Benson here. Oh, hi, Barbara. So, I see that you got Ben and Alice with you. Yeah, because we're all wearing polka dots. Yeah, well, I would have been like an adult mini. And Andy could be my adult mini.
Oh, thanks very much, Barbara. Yeah, very nice outfit, girls.
Thank you, Mr. Benson. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Okay, well, we all enjoyed wearing our polka dots to show off the boys, especially to Baby Lamb here. And Mr. Lamb, come on to the stage, why don't you?
Oh, all right. I'm glad what those girls look so, well, let's just say Cassandra and Belle are so adorable. Oh, and as for Alice, don't worry. I'm not calling you adorable because I understand.
Oh, thank you.
Well, let's just say you're awesome.
Thank you.
Well, anyways, everybody, that's pretty much all we can do for today's an audience with. But sadly, we're nearly coming to the end of this programme.
Oh, that's a bit sad, Baby Lamb.
Yeah, I know. Oh, and anyways, everybody, now before we go, now I'd like to say thank you all for watching me and all my friends doing something random. Yeah, because we came from a random verse in Capital City. Oh, and before I go, there's a few things I have to say about these girls there. They look adorable. I meant, Cassandra and Belle are so adorable in their outfits. Oh, and my girlfriend, Belle, looks like Minnie Mouse.
Thank you, Baby Lamb. You'll always be my Mickey Mouse.
Oh. Oh, gosh. I suppose I do look like Mickey. Oh, I wish I was acting like one. Oh, yes, and how can we forget Awesome Alice for her jumpsuit and nice yellow shoes, although.
Thanks, Mr. Lamb.
Yeah, you're very welcome. Now, anyways, now, can we have our last applause for those girls here? Oh, and me personally.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much, everybody. Thank you all for coming. And can we have one more applause for our guest of honour, the Bearson family, starting from Andy, Barbara, Ben, Lisa and Maggie here.
Oh, thank you. Everyone who's watching.
And also, not only that the Bearson family are guest of honours, we also got one special person to a special somebody. Oh yeah, that's two somebodies would be Alice Polonia, who danced with Bo earlier on, and sang this very special song. And also, let's give it up for one special star that came onto the stage, Mr. Bort Bearson. Well, thank you very much, everybody. Yeah, thank you for watching me. Yeah, and I hope I'll see you again soon. Oh, and I have to be back with my family after this. Yeah, that's right. Now, just do one final bow, Bort, and do final wave. Okay. Right, everybody. And that's definitely the end of an audience with now. So, as for me, Baby Lamb, and all my friends here in ITV Studios, I'd like to say bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye, and thank you all for watching, and good night. So long, folks.